liking it.
Well, it started about, it's going on its fourth year. It started out just a bunch of car enthusiasts getting together, meeting at different restaurants and talking about cars. And from there, it ended up, let's put a car show on.
I have
our breakfast every Saturday morning here at Rudy's. Everybody just get together and have coffee, donuts, whatever. Our entry fee is $20. And with that, they get a dash plaque, a homemade CD with oldies music, and Rudy's gives them a $5 meal ticket. I've been around cars since high school, dragging Polk Street, going to the drag races, and that started it. And it's once you start messing with cars, you're with them. I have a 1931 Model A two-door sedan. It has a 327 3.2s. I'm putting the interior in it right now. So it's gonna be, I won't bring it out here until it's finished, so. We do a 50-50. And the winner will walk away with half the money that's raised for the 50-50 for our charities. We helped one church out with a kids camp. More kids were registered and we heard about it and we took them, gave them some money to help out as part of the club. Another gentleman had cancer and we found out about it and they were doing kind of like a hamburger show and shine for him to help raise money for his medical expenses. So we took some of the money and gave it to them. So we just try to hear of people in need. We've given money to the 100 Club and just any kind of little organization that we hear that needs some help.
Well, this 40, it's about, we've had it about 9 years. Dad, he's always wanted a 40, so I went out about 9 years ago and found this one. It was just a rust bucket, and that's when the fun began. And 9 years later, we're pretty close to being finished. Well, we wanted to go with a small block Ford. We didn't want to go with what a lot of people do and do the Chevy and a Ford. We wanted a Ford and a Ford, and we really was looking for a 351, but we decided to go ahead and go with a 302, and we went ahead and stroked it, so it's actually a 347 stroker now. And the main thing is we wanted to stay Ford. I did all the body work and paint and all the metal fabrication, and Dad did all the powertrain. He did the motor and put 9-inch rear end under the back and put limited slip in it. The rear end came out of a Lincoln Versailles, so it's got disc brakes in the rear. The front suspension Dad put underneath it is a Super Ride from Heights, independent suspension. But basically all the powertrain was him, and all the metal fabrication and paint and everything was me. I've learned a lot about painting, and from the time I restored a 73 Super Beetle for my daughter, or 74 Super Beetle for my daughter, to this, learning how to do the body work, to when you put shiny paint on it that things won't show, and just laying the paint out, you learn something every time you do it. And I've got better, but I still have a long ways to go.
Entry number 66. Entry number 66, you're a winner.
We hit it on there.
You're on the spot, didn't we? Also, it's a 1952 Chevy Bel Air. It has like the original inline six motor in it, has a 1954 motor in it. It has no power steering. It has no air conditioning. Vacuum operated windshield wipers, which means the faster you go, the more your windshield wipers work. So the power steering part is the little bit of the toughest. You gotta figure out how to drive a power steering car. Because once you start going, then you can turn. You can't, like in a late model, just turn. You have to kind of have some turning and go. The way you start the car is, you know, turn the key on, but there's also a push button, and you got to push the button to make the car start. So that's how the starter operates like that. My parents were married 56 years last year. My dad recently passed away June 30th of this year. He restored this car. He and my mom dated, and when they dated in a 1952 Chevy, and so he restored a car just the same color, the same blue, the same white, as what they dated in. And so right after he got this car kind of running, he turned the radio on, and the first and only time this radio ever worked in this car, Elvis Presley played on the radio in this car. So he worked on it for probably about 4 or 5 years and got it restored. He did all the body work himself. He took some classes at Emerald College. He painted it. He did all his interior himself. In fact, what's so funny is he restored Volkswagens also. He restored a Volkswagen for my mother, myself, and my two sisters. So my dad restored cars. He was kind of a car guy all along, you know, all the time. So that was really cool. You know, he enjoyed his cars and stuff like that. This is like the hood ornament's like his most prized possession. It took him forever to find it. And so once he found it, you know, he had to have it kind of re-chromed and on. So I think that was kind of like one of his big joys to find was the hood ornament. The license plates are like original 1952 license plates that came on the car back then, and they were at a swap meet, my mother and my dad in Colorado. And Dad's like, nah, you know, I don't want to spend the money, so Mom bought them. She's like, nope, you've got to have the 52 plates on the 52 car. So Mom bought those for him at a swap meet in Colorado. Well, I would go and say, Dad, so he had to teach me how to drive. Okay, I'm 50 years old, and my dad is teaching me how to drive a car again. Because there's a certain way you gotta start it and a certain way you turn without power steering. So one night, you know, we have cruise night the first Saturday of each month. So I go to Dad and I say, Dad, you know, I'm 50 years old. And I'm saying, can I have the keys to the car so I can go to cruise night? And I have a curfew when I have to have his car back. So that's like one of my best, fondest memories of the whole car situation is being 50 and asking my dad for the keys to the car and having a curfew. So that just cracks me up.
This car is a 1938 two-door sedan. It's a Ford. The 38 is a deluxe. In 38, it was a very unusual year, actually. It's one of the few years that it was two totally different body styles between the standard and the deluxe. The standard is a humpback, and this one is obviously not. So there's a lot of difference between the standard and the deluxe in 38. No other year in Ford, and back in those days, it was basically the same car with two different grills or different headlights, but such as 39 and in 1940. I bought it from a gentleman that helped, that built it with his brother-in-law, and his brother-in-law passed away suddenly, just a little bit before they were quite done with it, and so they ended up selling the car, and I found it in Oklahoma City at an NSRA show over there. At least once a week, go somewhere, whether it's a car show or to the shop, which that happens a lot, and or maybe to go to dinner occasionally in it. So. The time of the shop was when, mostly to get it driving right, because when I first bought it, it drove kind of like a drunk steak on ice. And I mean, it was everywhere. It was actually extremely dangerous to drive. Actually, it was pretty good, really, until we decided to put power steering on it. And then it really got bad. And so it took a lot to get that ironed out. I mean, it basically changed almost everything in the front end. Most everybody says it's a really nice car. And I always ask them how they like the interior, because that's always, that was my big deal when I bought it. It's pretty wild. I mean, plum on the yellow, it's, yeah, that gets your attention. Unless you're an LSU fan or a Lakers fan, it's not exactly the colors. I love the yellow and I like the plum. I'm just not too sure about the combination.
They've helped us, they've let us put this on here. We shut down all of his drive-ups, everything. So they've really helped us.